Hey guys, welcome to Neat Video Tutorials. Here at Neat Video, it's our mission to help you avoid digital noise and improve video quality. This tutorial is an addition to our blog post on the topic of how to improve the quality of your aerial videos. If you haven't, make sure you check it out for a ton of information that will put you on course to creating killer drone shots. Now, in this video, we're going to talk about a few of the most frequent issues our customers run into when working with drones and what you can do about those issues. Ready? Let's get started and get those drone videos looking smooth and sexy. First up, let's talk about intensive sensor noise. This type of noise is often found in drone videos due to the small camera's limitations. Most consumer-grade drones have tiny camera sensors, and they don't handle low light well. The second most common problem is frame flicker. The problem here is that the video codec used by drones work by dividing clips into groups of frames, usually 8 frames per group. This group treatment creates slight differences between groups that are very noticeable in playback when you go from one group to another. Often this looks like a little jump in brightness happening over and over again. That's what we call frame flicker. The next issue is compression artifacts. The codec is the culprit here again. See, when the codec divides video into groups, it only records the first frame as a whole. The next 7 frames are recorded as the difference between the current and the frames that came before. The annoying blurry spots you see in some of these frames are the spots where codec didn't save some of the details. Hello, compression artifacts! And the last thing we're going to talk about today is blurry spots and shadows. This one is caused by in-camera noise reduction. You see, when you set sharpening to 0 or below, the drone's camera activates its internal noise reduction. As shadows naturally have more noise, the internal noise reduction jumps in and in the process ruins all the details there. And we're not going to let that happen on our watch. Okay, so now you know the issues, what can we do about this? The first thing is to set your camera's sharpening to +1 or above. This will deactivate the drone's in-camera noise reduction and preserve details. If there is noise, you can do a much better job of dealing with that in the edit. Speaking of the edit, when you add Neat Video, make sure you selected a keyframe first. To locate one, simply zoom in so you can see the slightest changes, then slowly switch from one frame to another. Now you need to pay attention to the details, compression artifacts, and how brightness changes. The keyframe has the biggest amount of the details, the lowest amount of compression artifacts, and most likely you will be able to see a jump in brightness. Okay, this looks like a keyframe. Now open Neat Video and build a noise profile using that keyframe. As usual, look for the area of the frame without details. Normally, we use After Profile at this point, but I've tried and it's very hard to build a noise profile for this particular clip. So I'm going to use one of our generic profiles. Now it's time to verify and, if necessary, adjust the noise profile using Noise Level Tuning Assist until almost all the noise is gone. Also, increase temporal filter radius to 5 and disable spatial filter. Click Apply. And here's the result! Spectacularly smooth drone awesomeness! That's what we like to see. We hope you found this tutorial helpful. Remember to check our blog for more information. And until next time, avoid the noise!